Hello friends, welcome to the Mail Theory channel. Today we're going to discuss about the Amazon DynamoDB. This is a beginner tutorial and we're going to explore what is Amazon DynamoDB and what are its features. And we will also give a walkthrough in AWS portal, like what exactly the features and what how you can use a DAX, which is nothing but a Dynamo DB accelerator also, to increase the performance and all that for the Dynamo DB. As a part of the lab, we will also do create a test tables, and we'll also create a DAX cluster, and we'll also see how to create a backups and how to have a point in recovery this thing. And we'll also see what are the different modes you can have, like demand mode and scalability features in the DynamoDB. Now let's understand first what is a DynamoDB. Okay, so I just want to give a quick introduction about myself. My name is Sai Kishore, and I have around like 8 years experience, worked with various companies in infrastructure technology space, but however currently working on more than multi-cloud and from last 8 years, like Azure, AWS, Oracle, Alibaba and others. And if you want, you can just add me in the LinkedIn. It is Sai Kishore Naidu. You can search with the ID. All right, thank you. So now let's understand what is a DynamoDB and its features. So let's see. So what is a DynamoDB? So a DynamoDB is nothing but a fully managed serverless key value, no SQL database designed to run high performance application at any scale. So, and it also offers a built-in security, a continuous backups, and automated multi-region replication, in-memory caching, and data export tools. So guys, the definition itself is very self-explanatory, says that, it is used to run high-performance applications. Now, what are the key features in DynamoDB? So I would say, from the performance point of view, I would like to see how many records it can hold. Now, what is the, how many million records it can, process as a request and all that. So it's something called as a DynamoDB key value, and, that can support up to any size of tables, right? So it enables, to scale more than 10 trillion requests per day. And look at the peak spike is 20 million requests per second and over petabytes of storage. So I think this sort of high scalability, high performance, I don't think I never seen in any other database recently across cloud platforms. I think DynamoDB is the first one of its kind who can process around like 20 million requests per second, right? And next thing is about the global replication, because obviously every enterprise grade applications require data to be replicated across various regions, various data centers and all that. So here in the similar fashion, AWS also gave a feature. You can replicate your global tables across AWS regions depending upon your business requirements. And what we'll do is it will globally distribute these applications, and data can you can access these regions to get a single digit millisecond read and write performance. Because the dilemma what we have is that if you replicate, and it increases the latency, of course, because it's in different region like east and west US and all that, right? So but here AWS promises that to get a single digit millisecond read write performance no matter in which AWS region is. This is really, really a good a commitment. Now let's look at the modes we have. We have a read write mode and we have on demand mode for the DynamoDB, guys. So it's nothing but the capacity modes for each table. On demand and provision for workloads that are less predictable, you can go for a read write capacity mode. But if you feel that hey, this table requires a very high performance read write, then it should go for the on demand mode. So you can define what kind of a capacity more you require for the particular table, which is a really, really a cool feature for me, so that you can ramp up or ramp down your traffic on each table. And because you know that which table will hit the, will have the high peak traffic, depending upon that, you can adopt this kind of a read-write capacity mode or on-demand mode. This is also a really cool feature which helps the application owners, which helps the product owners to define, what kind of a, what we call the, to predict and take a analysis, what we call an architectural decision. And the next thing is point-in-time recovery, because this is, I think, one of the major concern across the admins or the application owner. Hey, do we have a point-in-time? Because when you talk about a database, you see that, hey, I would like to restore the whole database and extract a single table out of it. But here, we're talking about only the tables. So DynamoDB gives you a flexibility of, 35 days of point-in-time recovery, which is also a very good feature. And I think this is one of the major, feature, for the enterprises, for any applications, all that, right? Because you have 35 days, that is more than enough from the development point of view, from testing point of view, from QA point of view. 35 days is more than enough to have all these versions, right? So now we understood what is a DynamoDB, and from the performance, global replication, read and write capacity, on-demand mode, and point-in-time recovery. Now, what we're going to do is we will quickly explore the AWS portal. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the portal overview of the DynamoDB, and we'll also talk about how to configure the DynamoDB accelerator for additional performance, for additional 10 times of caching and all that, so that I'm talking about like 20 million, 30 million requests per second. So you have to use the DynamoDB accelerator in the backend. We'll also look at the features in the AWS portal, okay? And finally, we'll talk about the summary of the whole video, okay? Now, let's quickly go to the portal. Now, so this is about the documentation. It's aws.amazon.com, DynamoDB features. You can see that here, what is new in the I'll just share this link in the description. You can, I want you guys to go through it. I'm not spending much time on this. Now, quickly, I would like to jump onto the DynamoDB dashboard. Now, log on to the portal and just type DynamoDB, guys. You will see this UI for the user. What are the features we have? We have a dashboard, we have tables, items, particular editor, backups, exports to S3, reserved capacity, and DAX cluster, and all that. Okay. Now, I click on the dashboard. It's asking for the reload. I'm sorry, just timed out. Just bear with me, guys. Okay, let me quickly log in. Okay. Sorry, bit of cold from last night. All right, so we logged in to the portal. Now, so what I would like to do is, currently I don't have anything. I just want to create a create table and see what are the input parameters when creating a table. So it says that schemaless database that requires only table name and a primary key when create a table. This is really awesome. I just want to create my first table. And key name is city. It's a string or it's a binary number, whatever it is. So default settings and customize settings. I'll go with the default. It gives that read write capacity and key management for the encryption at the rest. Table class, I don't want to have a, you can, if you want, you can add a tag and create a table. I'm just creating my first table in DynamoDB. Now you see that it provisioned with using read capacity mode. Okay, because we've selected the standard settings. Okay. Now once we created the table, so here you can create n number of tables. with whatever information required as per your application. Now I'll go to the items. Now any table tag I don't have, I'll select my first table here. Now I would like to create a new item in the table. So what is that? So I say that attribute name is city, value is something like let's say New York. I'm adding a table, create item. Now I've included an item in the table. Like this, you will create a lot of this thing. Now, what we have done so far, we create a table, we added a couple of items. I would like to add one more item also here. City is like, let's say, Bangalore. Create a table, create item in the table. So we've created, under city, we added New York, Bangalore, right? So now, so this is how you create a table and you create a what we call, like this. Now, this is using what this is using? Read capacity. If I want to create a demand mode, let's say, my second table. Now I'm not using a partition key. Now I want to use my location as a partition key, but I want to use a custom settings this time. So what is a custom setting will give? It says that what kind of a DB you want to use, right? You know, default is a general purpose table class, but you have a second one, which is a DynamoDB standard IA. Okay. So if I select this one, it says that, you know, with storage as a dominant table cost. But here this is like a general, like, you know, it's going to be a very read-write dominant table, but this is a storage based table. But I go to this one, I would like to see a capacity, which is like, you can also have a transactional cost or whatever it is, it depends upon you. And now here, look at the capacity mode. Now it's not on demand. Now you can select an on demand here. This is where under the custom, instead of selecting the default settings, you select the custom and then you'll go and select the on demand capacity. Now the same thing, you want to, what is the encryption level? It's owned by or AWS managed or by DynamoDB, or it's up to you. You can use your own managed by you. Now create a table. Now this table going to create as a read capacity on demand. Now we have learned provision with the default with the read write and second one is on demand. This is how you're going to create. Now I'd like to talk about the DAX clusters. What is a DAX accelerator? Okay, quickly see Amazon DynamoDB accelerator. Let's look at the quick documentation. It says that, hey, it's a fully managed, high available in-memory cache for Amazon DynamoDB that delivers up to 10 times performance improvements from milliseconds to microseconds, even at a millions of requests per second. This is a really cool feature because it says that it does all the heavy lifting required in to add in memory acceleration. So guys, so what it's going to do is, I'll go back here now. So I'm creating a lot of tables and, you know, I know that there will be a lot of million requests. So what Amazon is giving here is, what Amazon DynamoDB is giving, they will give a backend cluster where you can manage all these requests so that it increases your processing time. It decreases your processing time and increases your performance. So I'm going to create like my first cluster like this. Node families, you can use it using like, you know, T type and R type, but however you can use any type here. It says that, you know, you can see how many vCPUs you want to have. Like it's starting basic from 2 to 32 core and with 16 GB to 256. And network perform, look at guys, it's like from moderate to 10 gigabit. It starts with R5 to R5 8x large, and the number of nodes you can increase up to 3 to its maximum 11. So it depends upon, you can select, but I think the default is always select is like 2 CPU to 16 memory GB moderate and 3 node cluster. If I click on next, subnet, you can choose an existing one or you can create a new one. Okay, so you can always prefer to use this cluster subnet new one. So it's talking access control, G automatic, next. Okay, I'm sorry. So I need to select some. Okay, so click on next. So I'm also giving the permissions for the DynamoDB here. Like what kind of, because this is should be a DynamoDB specific IAM user, okay? So that I can create policy, read, write, all tables, encryption at next. Now choose existing parameter, like, you know, existing one, default DAX and all that. Maintenance window, no, if you want to specify the maintenance window, that applies for the software upgrades, patches and all that, you can specify like in every Sunday, starts within 1 hour, whatever it is. Enable maintenance notifications. I can create a notification email receipts, which is really nice also. Now I'm just uncheck this one, click on next. Now this is what you can change. See, there's one limitation, you cannot change the node type after the cluster is created. Make sure this node type fits your needs. So that you need to discuss with your admin and the application owner and the business owner and all that. Okay, so you need to look at from the futuristic point of view. Now I click on cluster. This is how you create a cluster. So it says I'm not sure because. So this is how you create the DynamoDB accelerator cluster. Now this is created. Okay. Now I'll go to the, it says item live to TTL is 5 minutes, 5 minutes query type, which is nice. And I do have any events, no events, subgroup groups, it gives that my existing subgroup. Okay, now we created a tables, we added the items. Now we also saw how to create a DAX cluster. The next thing is how to create the backups. Now, already there is a backup enabled, but I want to create an on-demand backup. What the on-demand backup? I can specify which table if I want to have a specific table. I'm selecting my first table. And I want to use the custom settings, backup with AWS backup, backup with the DynamoDB, right? So this is like includes a cross region, but additional features are not supported with, if I'm using a backup with, but better go with the backup with the AWS backup. Create backup now. How many days you want to transfer to cold storage? Retention period, always. It's you want to use a backup vault for, you want to create separate, sorry. So this is what is create backup. So I'm creating an on-demand backup here. Okay, so as does not have a sub, I think it's something to do with my choose an IAM file, which we created, right? Okay, so this is how you're gonna create, guys. I think, yeah. And the next feature is, cool feature is exports to S3. So I want to export to X3. S3 bucket. So how I can use it? I don't export any PTR and table. Okay. So I didn't enable this PTR table. But this is how you will export which table you want and select the S3 bucket. Just click on export. It will automatically export it, guys. There's nothing technology in that. So these are all the other features you have from the backup and exports to S3 bucket. And what is the reserved capacity now? So there are. Currently, I'm using a reserved, is nothing but you will be buying a capacity just like reserved instances. Click on purchase reserved instances. You can buy read capacity and write capacity on before. Okay, select 3 year, whatever it is, and upfront you're paying that, so then use for your standard read write operations. Okay, and quickly I would like to explore the pricing also, so that you know you'll have a complete picture. So there is a pricing for the provision capacity mode and there's a pricing for the on-demand capacity mode. It's completely different because this is on-demand is a completely unpredictable traffic, and provision capacity is for the predictable traffic, right? So if I want to calculate it, then I can click on the calculator.aws. So here I can do the estimation part here. Okay, create estimation. So before actually planning, you can select the DynamoDB product. So what are the features you want to have, like, you know, DynamoDB on cluster, DAX, backup, I want to use this. Okay, so you can select the 100 GB and one writes, okay, 100% transactional writes, let's say 50%, nahin, this is gonna be read write 50-50. Number of writes millions per month, I'm gonna say 10 million per month, let's say. Now it's gonna give that, I'm looking at the cost, it says that for the storage only for it's costing around $43.75. And for the similarly, you can have the calculation, you can show this to your customer or your application owner or whatever product owner to approve this. This is how you calculate it, guys, to have a better understanding. So let's a quick recap. So far what we have done is we have talked about the features of the DB, DynamoDB, and then we created the sample tables, and we also added items to the tables like this, and we also configured the backups, on-demand backup. And we also saw how to export to X3, S3 bucket, and we also covered the reserved capacity so that you can buy upfront. And we also created a cluster, okay, the DAX cluster, so that you know you can have the these are cluster monitoring and all that. I think you can start exploring that. Red settings, right? Yeah, so these are our settings and all that. And we also covered the pricing model. Alright guys, so I think this is about the DynamoDB, and I will share all these links in the description. And if you really like our video, request you to subscribe to our channel and like or comment if you like our video. Thank you so much. So this is The Mail Theory signing off.